Thank you. Would all please kneel for the reading of the Decalogue. God spake these words and said, I am the Lord thy God, who brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have none other gods but me. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not make to thyself any graven image, nor the likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or in the earth beneath, or in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor worship them. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Remember that thou keep holy the Sabbath day. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Honor thy father and thy mother. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt do no murder. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not steal. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not covet. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare thou those who confess their faults. Restore thou those who are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. The Almighty and merciful Lord grant you absolution and remission of all your sins, true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and consolation of his Holy Spirit. O Lord, open thou our lips, and our mouth shall forth thy praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The psalm appointed for the second Sunday of Lent is Psalm 16. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good above all other. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble among the people. But those who run after other gods shall have their troubles multiplied. Their libations of blood I will not offer, nor take the names of their gods upon my lips. O Lord, you are my portion and my cup. It is you who uphold my lot. My boundaries enclose a pleasant land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel. My heart teaches me night after night. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. For you will not abandon me to the grave, nor let your Holy One see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After these things, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham. And he said, here I am. He said, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I shall show you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him, and his son Isaac. He cut the wood for the burnt offering and set out and went to the place in the distance that God had shown him. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place far away. Then Abraham said to his young men, "Stay here with the donkey. The boy and I will go over there. We will worship, and then we will come back to you." Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac, and he himself carried the fire and the knife. So the two of them walked on together. Isaac said to his father Abraham, "Father," and he said, "Here I am, my son." He said, "The wood and the fire are here, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering?" Abraham said, "God himself will provide the lamb for a burnt offering, my son." So the two of them walked on together. When they came to the place that God had shown him, Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, "Abraham, Abraham." And he said, "Here I am." He said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him, for now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me." And Abraham looked up and saw a ram caught in a thicket by its horns. Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, "The Lord will provide," as it is said to this day, "On the mount of the Lord it shall be provided." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charges against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in our creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Jesus began to teach his disciples that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan. For you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. From our epistle for today. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. It will surprise probably no one that I was not much of an athlete. Gym class was more of a torment than an eagerly awaited break in the school day. It's hard for me to imagine my namesake, St. Paul, as much of an athlete, but he frequently uses athletic images. Perhaps he was more athletic than we know. One thing is for certain. His missionary journeys required endurance rivaling any sport one can imagine. In fact, he details the grueling abuse of his body in the things he endured both at the hands of others and from his own drivenness. Beatings, shipwrecks that left him floating at sea, harsh imprisonments, floggings, bandits, cold and hunger. God's grace was sufficient for him, as the Lord told him, and that grace was abundant. So Paul's language of being a conqueror speaks a profound word to us in the second Sunday of Lent. It hangs out as a promise, an assurance of one who knows. You, Christian, are a conqueror. You, and you are a conqueror in a specific way, through him who loves you. No matter our athletic standing, we have entered and received the gift of those who conquer. That is the long and the short of it. And yet we wonder, don't we? Spiritually speaking, we wonder if we have anything of the conqueror in us. Lent particularly causes us to wonder, is it possible to be a conqueror in Lent? Paul answers in a way we must hear again and again. It is an answer fundamental to the Christian life. He answers yes and no. No, not of ourselves. Yes, through him who loves us. And the most important thing is this: the yes carries the day. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. In Christ, we are held in the all-powerful love of the Father. Paul says, if God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? The love of the cross is our every assurance, the love that conquered this world. And to this we bear witness. But thanks be to God, who in Christ always leads us in triumphal procession, and through us spreads in every place the fragrance that comes from knowing him, Paul will say. It is central to the Christian life to live as one who has been baptized into the one who has conquered. Conquered by love for us. Conquered this world. And sent us forth as conquerors. Lent is many things, but Lent is fundamentally about Holy Week. The preparation we need to see clearly again what it is to conquer this world. to remember the one who loves us and sends us into this world in triumphal procession. Perhaps because of Paul's many imprisonments, the first image that always comes to mind is Paul locked in prison with Silas in Acts. Luke tells us, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. They were listening because they felt the power of that triumphal procession, the sweet fragrance Paul speaks of, much like the chrism with which we make the sign of the cross at baptism. How fitting, that fragrance. Lenten conquerors. You know, it's curious how it's difficult for Lent to find scripture that simply leaves us in despair. Ash Wednesday does a pretty good job, but how soon the triumphs mount up. Jesus in the wilderness, conqueror. Peter gets the wind knocked out of his sails today, but even this is held in our knowledge, that he will soon be first among the apostles, the rock on which Christ shall build his church. But Lent tells us, as the gospel today, the conqueror who loves us and his cross must lead the procession. There's great clarity today in what that means. Jesus says, if any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. We follow. We are followers. Led on this way by this triumphant sign, as the beloved hymn goes. Conquerors are followers. I cannot begin to count the number of times as a priest someone has shared these or similar words. You know, I don't know how people make it without faith. I always reply back that I couldn't even get out of bed without faith. But the expression is so telling. Christianity is a religion for those who know they need a conqueror of the real problem. And there is no way through the real problem but the way of the cross. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ, says Paul. The great but of the Christian life. But thanks be to God. Lent is more than to know where our hope is found. It is to find afresh the one who loves us and made us more than conquerors. To get back behind and follow. We will soon see that this world can be overcome in Christ. I have said this to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world, Jesus says. Year after year, we prepare for Holy Week to proclaim to the world that there is one who has overcome, that the cross is the way of life, that there is no shortcut, but there is a conqueror. Join the procession and sing the hymns, even from prison. Now, I acknowledge that this is not a normal second Sunday of Lent kind of sermon. In good form, we clergy would keep the Ash Wednesday sign of the cross from fading from memory. It's not my intention to break the momentum. But we cannot ignore the one who even now is breaking through, pointing to the resurrection triumph. If Lent is for one thing, it is to say clearly that no matter your or my sins, and quite because of them, we are invited to the triumphal procession, the nevertheless of the Christian life, which is the Christian life. Lent is bearable and only bearable because the triumph is already peeking through our sackcloth and ashes. We are more than conquerors through him who loves us. Know it. Believe it. Conquer fragrantly. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us, and grant us thy salvation. Endue thy ministers with righteousness, and make thy chosen people joyful. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in thee can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under thy care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let thy way be known upon earth, thy saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with thy Holy Spirit. O God, whose glory it is always to have mercy, be gracious to all who have gone astray from thy ways, and bring them again with penitent hearts and steadfast faith to embrace and hold fast the unchangeable truth of thy word, Jesus Christ thy Son, who with thee and the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, who didst will to redeem us from all iniquity by thy Son, deliver us when we are tempted to regard sin without abhorrence, and let the virtue of his passion come between us and our mortal enemy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, who didst so love the world that thou gavest thine only begotten Son to reconcile earth with heaven, grant that we, loving thee above all things, may love our friends in thee and our enemies for thy sake. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that we, being ordered by thy governance, may do always what is righteous in thy sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, who has made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and didst send thy blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near, grant that people everywhere may seek after thee and find thee. Bring the nations into thy fold, pour out thy Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of thy kingdom, through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We are invited to offer our own prayers and intercessions. Pray for the protection of our parish family, for all those who are ill from any cause. Mighty God, our Heavenly Father, we entrust all who are dear to us to thy never-failing care and love for this life and the life to come, knowing that thou art doing for them better things than we can desire or pray for, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen. Bow down before the Lord. Keep this your family, O Lord, with your never-failing mercy, that relying solely on the help of your heavenly grace, they may be upheld by your divine protection, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.